You may end up with a comical look hole where your head should be.
Hey, what's up everybody, Sam here. This is the Xiaomi HyperOS, which was just released yesterday. And here is the MIUI 14. So in this video, I will just demonstrate all the difference, what has upgraded, what has downgraded, you know, between the two. And yeah, this is probably the most comprehensive video about the HyperOS. So how about subscribing to my channel? Without further ado, let's get started.
All right, on the desk, we have one device with MIUI 14 and another one with the new HyperOS. Can you spot any differences? Take a moment to pause and make a wild guess. Okay, time to reveal. The device on the left is running MIUI, while the one on the right has HyperOS. Interestingly, there isn't a significant difference at first glance. Even though Xiaomi claimed to optimize this and that and add the AI features and so on, however, there are indeed some interesting changes. I'll categorize them into three aspects: interface, icons, AI privacy, and animations. Make sure to stick around until the end because I believe the animations are the coolest changes in HyperOS. Let's start with interface and icons. If you take a closer look, you'll notice that on the new HyperOS, the colors of the icons are less saturated. Some icons have also undergone slight design changes. For example, the gallery icon appears mirrored, and the nose icon now has a tick mark. These changes are quite subtle and you might need a magnifying glass to spot them. Why did Xiaomi do this, you ask? Maybe their designers just got a bit carried away? Who knows?
Lock screen, lock, you can see the lock, display, okay. Yeah, one thing you noticed immediately is the less saturated on the HyperOS. Fingerprint, security, privacy, and security. Okay, they adopt this new design, like this privacy, right? And the security, so battery. Okay, not the yellow one, before the green one. Yeah, some of the icons changed a little bit.
In the settings, HyperOS introduced advanced textures, which adds rendering effects like blurring across the system to enhance the visual experience. Well, this may be the case. It's not something I noticed immediately when trying to demonstrate it. Also, in the drop-down menu, it would be helpful if Xiaomi included text names for each item, as it can be challenging to distinguish between them. HyperOS has also made layout changes, such as in the background app section. In the photo album feature of HyperOS, three options have been added at the bottom: photo, album, and recommended. This makes it easy to hand photo samples with just one hand. In contrast, MIUI doesn't have these options. Additionally, some apps come with new features. For example, the calculator now has two arrows. Tap them will make it float, and you can access various layout options by tapping the three dots, allowing you to make it full screen or move it to top or bottom, which was not available in MIUI 14. Now, let's discuss AI and privacy. This section is quite short and there's much to show. HyperOS supports connections with multiple devices for sharing. Although I don't have many compatible devices to demonstrate this feature, in terms of privacy, when you crop a picture within a messaging app, HyperOS automatically blurs the avatar and phone number if they are present in the dialogue. That's a clever privacy feature. One feature I really appreciate is AI image background removal. You can isolate the subject in image, change the background, resize it. The results are quite impressive with the clean edges, even better than me using Photoshop, in my opinion. However, be mindful that when selecting pictures without something to block your face, you may end up with a comical look hole where your head should be. Now, onto the most exciting part, animations. HyperOS offers numerous cool and subtle animations. Let's start with the weather app. When you open it, the background image now matches your current weather more closely. For example, The clouds in HyperOS are more pronounced, giving the appearance of a genuinely cloudy day. Regarding the haze weather in Delhi, I don't know if any Delhi friend has left a message there. Let me know which image aligns better with your experience. Swipe up. The new HyperOS also includes separate icons for various weather indices in the drop-down menu, making it more intuitive and direct compared to the older version. One of the coolest animations is the rain effect in the new HyperOS. When you move the menu bar, you can see raindrops falling on the frame and bouncing back, just like a real raindrops hitting the ground. This effect is not available in MIUI and adds vibrancy to the user experience.
So cool, okay.
In the case of the recorder app, when you start recording, it will prompt you that the phone is entering silent mode. Furthermore, when you exit the app, it will present a really cool animation as it flies to the top left corner, a feature not offered by the old system. I also noticed other animations, such as when you are moving a large folder, you can see the apps moving around. Compared to MIUI, it feels like everything is more dynamic. HyperOS introduces new charging animations. When you're charging, a window pops up at the top displaying the charging method and percentage. To be honest, I prefer the old animations as they exude a more tech-savvy vibe, and the new ones are a little bit less appealing to me. There are also some really subtle changes, like when you scroll down, the status icons move with your gestures. I just don't understand why Xiaomi puts so much effort into these small animations that hardly anyone would notice. It's quite surprising, to be honest. Lastly, Xiaomi claims that the new system is more powerful and smoother, allowing for the opening of more apps without experiencing any stutter. However, in my tests, I found that MIUI 14 felt smoother and performed better, maybe. Keep in mind that the devices I'm using are demo units and still in the early stages, so the official release might offer a different experience. Creating this video took a lot of time, so please consider subscribing and giving it a like. Your support is greatly appreciated, and it's entirely free. And here's my conclusion right after using HyperOS for some time. It should be pretty genuine.
All right, and that's all the difference and what do you think about it. And to be honest, it has really, really, really subtle changes. So if you didn't mention it, if you didn't say it, I wouldn't even notice at all. But I do feel like the Xiaomi HyperOS, I don't know, the MIUI 14 feels very smooth as well. Maybe a little bit more vivid, more like vibrant, you know. But anyway, that's all the difference, and let me know which features do you like most on the HyperOS, and which one Xiaomi should keep from the previous MIUI systems. Just let me know, and thanks for watching. Subscribe if you haven't, because I always do this kind of genuine, non-paid, honest videos. See you the next time. Bye-bye.